Is that card luck?
Greetings, Shield Brother. Of course, my fellow Harbingers and I have been warming ourselves here, trying to evade Hirsi. You see only me because your heart knows only me as the Companion's leader. I'd wager old Vignar could see half a dozen of my predecessors. And I see them all. The ones in Sovngarde, the ones trapped with me in Hirsi's realm. And they all see you. You've brought honor to the name of the Companions. We won't soon forget it. Did he now? I can only hope. You still have the witch's heads. Excellent. Throw one of them into the fire. It will release their magic. For me, at least.
So, what would happen if you didn't have any of those heads with you? Maybe the heads can't be removed, but I know in previous playthroughs I've been able to sell those heads. And then wish I didn't do it. But I don't remember why.
This is good.
That's some of the worst effects I've ever seen.
You don't scare me.
A fight.
A fight? Where? Oh, this? That's not a fight.
You're
it's a petting zoo.
Bastard, aren't you? You're a creep.
Man, this thing's taking a while to die.
You're as good as dead.
You're good. I wish I could use an axe that well.
I killed it with just a wood axe. Wood chopping axe, anyway.
Greetings, Shield Brother.
Did you know?
And so slain the beast inside of me. I thank you for this gift. The other Harbingers remain trapped by Hirsi. Perhaps from Sovngarde, the heroes of old can join me in their rescue. The harrowing of the hunting grounds. It would be a battle of such triumph. And perhaps someday, you'll join us in that battle. But for today, return to your vessel. Triumph in your victory. And lead the Companions to further glory.
Oh, where's Aella? She hops out of nowhere usually when this happens. Oh, here she
goes. Did I hear right? Did he say you were to lead the Companions? You've earned the right. Your strength and honor are apparent to all. And it's my honor to be first to address you as Harbinger. Let's go tell the others.
Hands to yourself. What now?
Oh, she's with us.
I'm ready if you are.
Who invited her?
Right behind you. I'm right behind you.
She's ignoring. I grab a weapon, she doesn't grab her weapon, so something's wrong with her.
I'm glad you're here with me.
Maybe I had to just reset her.
Let's make some more stories.
I'm so glad that you're helping me to track down my flute. We mustn't forget to ask around for it among Kaid's bards and innkeepers.
Of course.
And it's Villia with her floss armor.
Shall we continue?
Okay, so she can't fight when she's trying to cover herself up. I'm gonna call her Modesty Blaze. Yeah, that animation does not help during combat scenes. She's supposed to be swinging her sword. I didn't read that before I grabbed it. I thought it was a helmet, but it's the whole armored set. Or not set, but it's just the whole orcish armor, which I don't want. That's too heavy. I thought it was an orc helmet. Oh well. Oh, what else did I grab? Grabbing crap off the shelf I don't need. Oh, now I got the hiccups. Why?
I'm so glad that we're traveling to Eldeglin Sanctuary together. The Skyrim wilderness is so scary when you're all alone.
Of course.
My frame rate lags whenever Papyrus needs to add up all the weight that I'm carrying. So every time I pick up something, it adds more to my encumbrance. Then the game acts like it's going to freeze while it's counting up all the little tiddlywinks that I'm walking around with. Each one has weight to it. Oh, I can't give her any more?
Anytime.
Right behind you.
Maybe Serana can carry some of this junk.
Anything good? Let's go.
So what am I wearing? Maybe I was wearing just a mage outfit so I could have plenty of magicka. But I don't know if that works with orcs. Enchanted weapons seem to have no effect with orcs. Orcs can only use the actual weapon. They don't.
Yes. Of course.
They don't make use of the enchantments on the weapon. But whatever damage the weapon can do, orcs seem to be able to do more damage than what the mill spec says about it.
Anytime.
Okay, she's. Villia's got issues. If I go outside, maybe she'll reset. Then all of her weapons will show up instead of swinging air. She'll be swinging a battle axe. Okay, so wet and cold's making me run slow because I'm slowly turning into a popsicle. I remember I had a mod once where if you're freezing to death out in the snow, you summon a Dremora or a Flame Atronach and you stand next to it and it warms you up so you don't freeze solid. Those were the days. Unfortunately, those mods conflict with the combat mods I'm using now. Mods like Ordinator, Wildcat.
Would you like something to drink?
Imperious.
Well, if you say so.
I lumped them all into combat mods because they affect the combat of your character. So to me, that's a combat mod.
Anytime.
To others, it may be a lore mod. It just makes your character more lore-ish. Or acts in ways that are more lore-friendly. Or mods that force your character to be lore-friendly. Can you believe it? Can you believe that there are such things?
Couldn't you please teach me to summon something too? It doesn't need to be anything impressive. A cat, maybe. Or at least a skeever.
I mean, how do you crystallize something that's lore into something calculable that a computer can actually use in a computer game? Use it as a mechanic. Is there like a lore mechanic in the game code somewhere? The computer determines, is this lore or is it not lore? Is there a canon function in role-playing games like this? To see if something's canon or not? Oh wow, I'm taking a shortcut somewhere.
That was a close one. I don't know, but this place is full of them. Everyone I've encountered has been enchanted or the like. Look, I'm getting out of here. Normally spiders make my skin crawl, but magic spiders?
So some quest sent me here to pick up a weapon?
Is there anything more revolting than spiders? Too many legs.
This is one of those script-heavy dungeons with the ridiculous door key. I was shocked that my first try I was able to get the door to open. I just can't stand scripted combat. Because if scripts misfire, then guess what? The scene breaks and the combat does not finish or end ever. I ran into that problem this morning. With One Eye, Olaf One Eye. His script jammed, and the next thing I know, the bard's quest was never finishing. That would be weird if Bethesda made that flaming spider trick just for this quest, and it's not like used later on in the game. No spiders coming at you that shoot fire. Like how the ants come at you and shoot fire in Fallout 3. But maybe it was only used for this one effect, for this one quest here. Okay, here's that stupid door key. Just by luck, it all opened up. So I saved it right then. It's like, I don't want to have to mess with that lock ever again in the game. I'm sure it was doing something like a mastermind trick where it tells you which levers were in the right spot and which lever was wrong. But I don't have time to figure out that nonsense. Just open the damn gate.
Be careful.
Stay on your guard.
Oh, I had to take a power nap just now. I was probably rambling on the last 15 minutes. Sleep deprivation, you know, that kind of thing. So, who knows, maybe the next 15 minutes I'll say something intelligent. Where are we? Oh, we're killing dead spiders that are already dead. If you touch the spider, they reveal what magic they have. Either fire, or the electricity one, or the frost one, is that right? Maybe it's only frost and fire. That'd be pretty rare if a spider did electrical stuff. Is it just me?
Yes, what is it?
Just Velia and Serana with this? What's the plan here? Oh, they're shooting at the ceiling? Is there... Maybe there's one stuck in the ceiling that hasn't come down yet. I have so many area of effect mods installed that it affects the scripted combat scenes sometimes. Okay, what are you doing over there? She wants to do one of her little tumble things that she does. The baby! It's the baby! Did that one come down yet? Too much glare comes off of these spiderwebs. Maybe I need to find some better looking spiderwebs than the one I'm using. Something that works better with the EMB. I need to find better water and better... better webs. Maybe there's a mod called Better Water, Better Webs for EMB. That'd be great. Because my water tends to glow, like the waves, when the waves break on the ocean, they glow. In webs, they tend to glow as well. I don't want my webs to glow in the dark. You coming? Okay, forget Serana. Maybe she'll figure it out later. Or this place isn't meant to have more than one follower in here. Sounds like the third world outside. What's going on there? This guy likes to talk to his spiders, and then his spiders like to clip through the jail cell that they're in. The spiders are supposed to be in the little cage he's got set up there. They almost always manage to walk through the stupid cage door.
Sure.
It breaks the whole fight scene, if you ask me. So I thought I'd try killing him first. I think he pulls a lever and then the spiders come out, or you're supposed to sneak down there and pull the lever and then the spiders will kill him. Either way, it seems pretty lean. Pretty lame. Then at this point you're wondering, why am I even in this dungeon? Do I even care about this guy's backstory or not? This is a one-hit wonder kind of thing. And it wasn't really a one-hit either. It's just a one-shot deal. You do it once and you probably never come back here again. So he does frost, fire, and shock. What a shock. When all else fails, just get out the SAM stick. Oh, what happened here?
How are you doing? You don't look well at all.
I guess she's out of the action.
Where are we going now?
There we go. Don't rape him, just kill him. Oh, he healed up. Tried to heal up. So see, we got a spider here. It won't attack us because the spider still thinks it's inside the cage. But once I open this thing here, all of a sudden they become crazy. Crazy spiders. They hate us now. They hate us for letting them loose. Okay. And the key is nothing special. I think it's just... What's the deal with the key? Why are we even here? Okay, so the key, I guess, gets us to another room that gets me to the chest that I came here for. You only come here to get something out of a chest. At the end of the map. Okay, there's a chest that has the thing I need. It's usually something bland. The most blandest thing in the chest is what I came for. So I can put back the other junk.
I'm so glad that we're traveling to Eldegrin Sanctuary to... Of course.
Was that a side boob I just saw? I just noticed it. Well, that's weird. You can sleep here? I remember...
You need something? All right, then.
It was either Morrowind or an Oblivion. If you slept in a bed like that one, you had a chance of getting a disease of some kind. I may have even had one for Skyrim that did that. After a while, you're so immune to diseases in Skyrim, it's like diseases are no longer a thing in the game. So you have to manually add the disease to your character. If you want to roleplay getting sick.
Leave him alone.
No. Because I think, why, you know, if you're a werewolf, if you've got the werewolf whatever in your blood, then you're immune to diseases. Or if you're a vampire, you're immune to diseases. You know, that kind of thing. And then if you're just super good, then, you know, level 50, I think you just naturally become immune to everything. And then there's... Oh, there's another chest? Oh, this is the last resort. In case there was nothing else in the game, you got this one chest here. Okay, now we can leave. My companions never know how to follow me back to where I was. If I just leave, they'll meet me outside. So I got this one sex lab mod where if you have sex with a random stranger outdoors, like a bandit or a crack whore or whatever, there's a chance you'll get a disease from them. So I thought that's cool. So diseases are back in my game. Blonde, really?
Yes. Lead on.
Yes? So, where are we going now?
One of my coworkers yesterday had hair. Had hairstyle exactly like Serana's hairstyle right here. And I almost said to her, it's Serana! Serana has arrived! She wouldn't know what I'd be talking about, though. Serana? Is that really you? You know, that kind of thing.